You are my spirit. Bye. but do not have love, I am nothing. If I give all my possessions to the poor, I give over my body to hardship, that I may boast. But do not have love, I give nothing. Love is patient, love is kind. It does not envy, it does not boast. It is not proud. It does not dishonor others. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrong. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always preserves. Love never fails, but where there are prophecies, they will cease. Where there are tongues, they will be stilled. Where there is knowledge, it will pass away. For we know in part of we prophesy in part. But when completeness comes, what is in part disappears. When I was a child, I talked like a child. I thought like a child. I reasoned like a child. When I became a man, I put the ways of childhood behind me. For now we see only a reflection as in a mirror. Then we shall see face to face. Now I know in part, then I shall know fully, even as I am fully known.
I know these three things remain, faith, hope, and love, but the greatest of these is love. Amen.
The greatest story ever told to mankind. What do I do, or what can I say about this verse? For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish but have everlasting life. This is the greatest love ever shown to mankind. A mother or father of their child is in near and cannot compare to God's love. God's grace, God's love each and everyone, good or bad, any part you choose, God still loves you to the end, to your death. God's gift, God sent his only begotten Son to die for our cursed souls. Not just that, everything you have, God gave us as a gift. The food you eat, the talents you have, the games you play, the clothes you wear, and many more. Yeah, maybe you bought it or trained to have it, but God gave you or your family member the money to buy it and the energy to train yourself. God's gospel. Whoever believes in him should not perish but have everlasting life. It is in God's heart that no one should perish. He wants all his sons and daughters to live in him in paradise. God's glory, everlasting life with him in paradise. What joy to live with God all the days of our lives in peace and harmony, singing praise of his love. Jeremiah 30 verse 3 says, I have loved you with an everlasting love. I have drawn you with an unfailing kindness. God's love for us is infinite and can't be compared with nothing else or no one. There is a chorus that says God's love is as wide as the ocean, deep as the sea, and high as heaven above. His love surpasses all. It is for you and I, big or little, poor or rich, black or white. Everyone and every language share God's everlasting love. So brothers and sisters in Christ, let us honor God with our lives and thank him for his love. Thank you.
Troubles are so great. We don't know what to do. The price for our iniquities is finally coming to you. The Lord is crumbling. The world is crumbling all about, no safe place to fall. Right is wrong, wrong is right. The change is quite profound. Lord, we need you. We need your glory in life to lead us out of your will, future and your world and prayer to take away our fear, temptation of this dying world. We'll rule out and let go. Give our burden all to you. Shield all worldly hope. That we will get through this. Lord, fix and heaven above. And serve of your protection, help and everlasting love.
So we rush out.
by his help.